Do you know, this is from 7-5, right?
It's from our current one, our current chapter, but it's part of the pre-test thing.
Yeah. Oh, it's a practice problem? Oh, but I told you I wasn't going to put hyperbolic on, but we'll still solve it. All right, so this did come from the midterm practice exam. This problem I'm about to write down, but I won't put hyperbolics on there, but you still do need to know how to solve this. Yeah, I could put a similar problem up. I mean, it may not work out if I just erase all the H's, but I'm sure I can make a similar problem that would work out in regular trig, with regular trig functions. All right, so definitely we need a U sub on this one, for sure, just looking at it. So the question is, what should I choose for U? So we could try to take what's in the square root. Maybe that will work out. I'm going to go just for something. I always try to go small first and then kind of pick up bigger stuff. So let's just do cotangent, hyperbolic cotangent first. So du derivative tangent and secant squared. So this is cosecant hyperbolic squared x. And is there a negative sign on this derivative? Let's see. Derivative is negative, yes. All right, so we got a slight problem. There's no cosecant squared. I could write this as negative 1 over hyperbolic squared dx, but I don't have a sine h squared. I got sine h, but not sine h squared. So this is not going to help us out too much here. This is definitely written down correct off there. Oh man, I made an impossible problem. So let's think about what else we can do. So when in doubt, remember, you always can use algebra. So let's rewrite cotangent as cos over sine. So maybe that will give us some insights. Maybe it won't.
Can we split it up like 1 over cos, 1 over sine?
We could rewrite it in some different ways. So I go 1 over cosh, 1 over sinh, 1 over square root. This is 9, I'm going to write as 3 squared minus cosh over sinh, whole thing squared. All right, so I have a crazy idea. Let's uncross out our substitution. How in the world, so I'm gonna erase what I just wrote. How can I write, I'm gonna get a sinh squared in the denominator. So what I want is a sinh squared in my denominator. That's what I got out of my U substitution. So what I'm going to do is just put one in there. Of course, that's illegal. Yep, unless I put a cinch on the top as well. So that's equal to the previous term, right? Or previous antiderivative. Now I got my cinch squared. However, I got an extra cinch. So this one I'm going to move over to the first fraction. Oh, I still have my cinch squared x. There will be a U outside, basically, but unfortunately, I'm not quite ready yet.
And the cinch from the top only has to be distributed to one of the three split.
Yeah, that's how multiplication works. That's for distributing multiplication over addition. So like, you're probably thinking this. This is AB plus AC. However, A times BC, that's either, you can think of this as AB times C, or you're just reassociating is all you're doing. Or this could be, what else? A times BC, you're just kind of grouping differently. Or ABC, yeah. I mean, technically multiplication is a binary operation, meaning you can't multiply three numbers at once. The way you do it is you multiply two of them, and then you multiply a third one into the product. So we do write ABC because we know it doesn't matter which two are grouped together. So it doesn't matter which of the two I multiply first. The same thing is true with addition. You can't really add three things at one time, but you add two of them and then add the third thing. All right, let's go ahead and make the U sub here.